CTW presents Sesame Street Show 2280, produced at Reeves Teletape, New York City.
That's not such a big problem.
That is only half of my problem.
126 hiccups.
That is the other half of my problem. Yeah. And all this thunder and lightning is giving me a headache.
127 hiccups.
Will you stop that, please?
I wish I could, but I can't help myself. A hiccup is to count. Sorry.
Listen, all you have to do is get rid of the hiccups and he'll stop counting. Why don't you? I've heard that this works. Try holding your breath. Some people believe that that'll stop the hiccups.
Holding your breath.
It's holding your breath.
Okay, I'll try it.
Hiccups.
Nope, didn't work.
No.
Got any other theories?
Well, some people think that if you frighten the person that has the hiccups will go away!
Ha ha! 129 hiccups!
That didn't work.
No.
Well, I know I have this one last thing you could try. Now, it's a little weird, but some people think that if you drink a cup of water with your fingers in your ears, the hiccups will go away. It's not easy, but it might work.
Okay. A cup of water with your fingers in your ears. How do you do that? You're a genius!
Good, thank you.
You're a genius.
So much. Well, something was gonna work, I was sure.
Party pooper.
I will see you later.
Okay. Gesundheit.
Aha! One sneeze, one Gesundheit.
Oh, my hay fever.
Two sneezes.
Gesundheit.
Two sneezes, two Gesundheit.
Don't you start with me, Count. I'm getting out of here.
Maria, wait for me. Sneezes are my specialty. Wait, three sneezes. Only two Gesundheit, but three wonderful sneezes.
Okay, showtime.
Oscar, what showtime? What have you got us all here for anyway, huh?
Hold your horses, you'll find out.
What?
Not a bad house. Well, welcome to Oscar's special exercise and number show, starring me and...
And me. And listen, everybody. Me. Oscar's gonna call out a number, and I get to do some exercise that number of times. Oh, I hope it's a big number, because I love to do exercise.
Well, the number for today is the number 12. Mm-hmm. That's a big number.
Ooh, wow. Just think, 12 sit-ups or 12 push-ups. That'd be great.
Harry, if you keep yakking, you're going to be too tired to do exercises.
Okay, I'm ready.
Now, ladies and germs, boys and squirrels, a little humor there.
Yeah, little.
For our first exercise, we're going to show you jumping jacks.
Ooh, I love jumping jacks. I can do 100 jumping jacks.
Yeah, but the number of jumping jacks I want you to do is...
Yeah.
Zero.
Zero.
Zero. Zero. But zero is none. Nothing.
That's right. And the number of jumping jacks I want you to do is none.
Come on, Oscar. What's that?
Well, you did zero jumping jacks just perfectly, Harry. Now let's have a little applause there for our athlete, huh?
But
good. Okay. Now for our second exercise, we're going to watch Harry do toe touches.
All right. Yeah, those are good, too. Now, how many toe touches do I get to do?
The number of toe touches we're going to see Harry do is... Zero.
Hey, but zero means I don't do any.
What a star, huh? Look at this guy. Zero toe touches without a single mistake.
Oscar, this is ridiculous.
Hey, why don't you sit down before you fall down, Mr. Fix-It? Now, watch carefully, everyone, as Harry lifts his incredible 100-pound barbell.
I'm ready. Only this time, you better give me some...
The number of times that Harry will lift this amazingly heavy barbell over his head is zero.
Oh, Oscar, doing zero exercises is zero fun. And you know how many more zero exercises I'm gonna do for your silly show?
How many?
Zero. None.
Oh, yeah.
And Oscar, do you know how many of us in your audience are going to stay and watch this?
Zero. None.
Come on, kids, let's go.
You know, zero is really my favorite number.
Boy, it's getting awfully windy. I wish I had something heavy, like a rock, to keep these papers here from blowing away. Or maybe even a book.
Egad! It is I, Sherlock Hemlock, the world's greatest detective. You say you need a book.
Yeah, or a rock or something.
Oh, this is indeed your lucky day, because I happen to have my all-purpose unabridged detective's dictionary with me.
Hey, great. That would be perfect.
Yes, indeed. Perfect for looking up the exact definition of what we want. You see, detectives always look for clues. And dictionaries are just full of clues about what things are. So we're going to look up book, because you are looking for a book and not a choo-choo train. Now, let's see. Book. Aha! Here it is. Book, a collection of printed pages. Say, here's a stack of printed pages right here. Detective work is so satisfying.
But, Mr. Hemlock, this isn't a book. It's just a pile of papers that
Perhaps you're right. Maybe I should consult my dictionary again for another clue.
But you don't understand, Mr. Hemlock. That dictionary would be perfect for what I need here.
You're right. Dictionaries are perfect because they are full of clues. Ah, and here's another clue. It says here that a book is a collection of printed pages that are bound together. No, those papers are not bound together. That is not a book. Perhaps we need even more information. Aha! The detective unearths another clue. Listen to this. Book, a collection of printed pages that are bound together with two covers, front and back.
Right, and they can be big and heavy, like...
Now, let's see if there's anything around here that has a bunch of printed pages bound together with a front and back cover. No, I don't see anything around here.
Mr. Hemlock, that dictionary...
Oh, I'm sorry, my friend. That dictionary has nothing else to say about what a book is.
No, but that dictionary is a book.
Mm-hmm.
Itself. It's a bunch of printed pages bound together with a front cover and a back cover, see?
Amazing. Yes, good detective work saves the day again. Don't bother thanking me, my bird. Just have a good time reading your book.
But I didn't want a book for reading. I just wanted something heavy to put on top of these papers so that... Oh, no, no. Stop. No. Because of the wind.
Ah, yes. Wind. Let's see. Yes, wind, wind. Any natural movement of air of any speed...
Maria?
Yeah?
I've been thinking about the word original. I mean, it means that it's something that's never been done before, right? Is that what original means?
Right, something that's absolutely new.
Well, you know what? I'd like to do something that is completely original.
Well, that's very nice, but it's kind of hard.
Yeah? Well, I don't see what the big deal is. I mean, it can't be so hard to think up something that's never been done before. Something that's never been done before. Like this. Suppose I stand here in front of you, and you look, and I'm not just standing here, but you see, ta-da, I'm on 1 foot. Ha-ha.
Yeah, well, that's very nice, Big Bird, but it's not original. It has been done before. I'm sure that somebody has stood on 1 foot.
I guess you're right. Well, no problem. I'm sure I could think of something else. How's this? Suppose I sing a song as loud as I can. You always hurt the one you love.
Big Bird, that's very nice too, but it's not original. I'm sure that somebody has sung as loud as they could before.
Well, you know, being original is a lot harder than I thought.
Yes, it's very hard, I told you.
Say, I just thought of something. Suppose I could take a parrot. And make that parrot hide. That would be really original.
Before you do that, Big Bird, take a look at this.
You know, that's not fair. That parrot did exactly what I said I was going to do.
Yeah, well...
Hi, Maria. What's up?
Hi. Big Bird's trying to think of something original to do, something that's never been done before.
Oh.
Yeah, Bob. And the minute I figure out something original to do, it turns out somebody has already done it before me. It wasn't original at all.
Oh. Well, how about singing as loudly as you can, Big Bird? Sorry, just kidding.
Got an idea. What if I get a bunch of kids together and I get them to make their bodies into triangles and squares?
Well, how are you going to do that?
I'll think of a way. First, I got to go find the kids.
Wait a minute. Hold it, Big Bird. I think before you do that, you should take a look right here. I don't know, Big Bird. I wouldn't feel bad if I were you.
Easy for you to say, Bob.
Wait a minute. Why does Big Bird feel bad?
Well, I've been trying to come up with something original, something that nobody's ever done before. But everything I think of turns out somebody's already done it. Wait. I got it. I know nobody's ever thought of this. Oh, boy.
What is it, Big Bird?
Well, get a load of this. This is going to knock your socks off.
Yeah?
I'm going to get me a whole bunch of zebras.
Zebras?
Yes. zebras, and I'm going to get them all to slide down a slide. And see, I'm going to have a big pool of water at the bottom of the slide so that they come down the slide, they'll splash into this big pool of water. Now, I know that's original. Now, where can I get a bunch of zebras?
Big Bird.
Oh, don't tell me you're going to tell me that this is already done before.
No, I'm going to tell you that there aren't any zebras on Sesame Street.
Oh, right, right. Well, no problem. No zebras. Forget the zebras. I'm sorry I ever brought them up. They're history. Because instead of zebras, I'm going to do it with penguins. Penguins, that's it. Boy, excuse me. I got to go find some penguins.
Big Bird, wait a minute. I hate to tell you this, but take a look.
I suppose you're wondering why I've called you all here together.
Yeah.
Well, you know, all day long I've been trying to think up something original to do. I just couldn't think of anything at all. I tried to hide a parrot. Somebody already hid a parrot. I tried shapes. They did shapes. I tried penguins. Somebody already did penguins.
You're upset, aren't you, Big Bird?
Yeah. And I wrote a poem about how upset I feel.
Oh, yeah.
Don't suppose you want to hear it.
Sure. Yeah, sure. Can we hear it?
Okay. I tried to be original. Did everything I could. But nothing that I thought of was really any good. To really be original, you must do something new. Something never done before. Like a rooster saying moo. But everything I tried to do had all been done before. I felt that I should give it up and not try anymore. But then I thought, why get upset and full of pain and sorrow? Instead, I think I'll try to be original tomorrow.
Big Bird! Big Bird, that's great! It's a terrific poem, and it's original.
Yeah.
Original? What do you mean?
That's an original poem, Big Bird. No one in the whole wide world has ever written that poem before.
Yeah, you're the very first one.
Right.
Yeah. Gosh, I never thought of that.
Right.
Wow, you mean I was original after all.
Exactly. Yeah, you were.
Oh, boy. I feel a lot better.
Good, Big Bird. And now I have an idea that's not very original.
Really? What's that?
What's that?
I'm going to take this very original bird to bed.
Oh, boy.
Oh, yeah, it's time.
Good night.
I'm going to sleep.
Buenas noches, Big Bird.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters I and Y and by the number 12.
Imagine that.
Making up an original poem.
Never thought I'd do anything.
Good night, my very original bird.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.